Good evening friends, I'm again with you in this new video, and in this video I am particularly going to shed some light on the speaking module again of our IELTS exam. And as we all know that our speaking is divided into three parts, and we call them part 1, part 2 which is cue card, and part 3 which is discussion. And today I am going to tell you something very important about your preparation for the part 1 of the speaking module. Okay, so we are going to talk about part 1 of IELTS speaking. So first of all, let me tell you, this part 1 is about you. So in the very first part of the speaking, you will be facing some direct questions, and those questions will be targeted only at you. For example, there will be topics like what type of clothes do you wear, from where you buy those clothes, in future will you have the same choice or would you like to make any changes, or maybe they will talk about something like your favorite color, which one is your favorite color, and why it is your favorite color, or probably they will talk about your favorite food, which is your favorite food. So as I told you, this part 1 is about you. Now you don't have to talk about people, you only have to tell, answer the direct questions: what type of clothes you wear, what is your favorite color, what type of food you like. So all the questions are related to you. Now what mistakes mostly students make, I'm going to tell you what mistakes normally students make. First mistake is that very short answers. Okay, very short answers. Example is, for example, they are asking you, do you like to eat different type of food, do you like to try new food, and we are saying yes. So yes and no answer, only yes and no, that is a wrong way. We can't give very short answers. Okay, now you will be thinking that if we can't give single sentence answers or very short answers, then how much should be the length of the answer? I can't give you exact length, but I can tell you what is the structure. So you will have to add some detail to your answers or some reasons, and I think a couple of reasons are enough. For example, if they ask you, do you like to try new food, you can't simply say yes, I like to try new food. That is very short answer. You'll have to add some detail. You can say, of course I love to try new food because, you know, in this way I can expand my taste, and I can also know that what type of other foods are available and about the nutritional value of those foods. So this is an example of adding the detail. Or you can give an example also. And so how we can do this? We always think of why. Okay, always think of why. So do you get up early in the morning? Mostly students say, of course I get up early in the morning, but they don't add any detail. The real key is, if you get up early in the morning, yes or no, why? or some detail like the timing or the reasons of getting up early or the example when why you normally get up early. So the ideal answer can be, of course, I like to get up early in the morning and I can say that I am an early bird. And why I like to get up early in the morning? Because I believe that if I get up early in the morning, I have enough time to complete all the tasks of my day-to-day life and I can become more productive during the whole day if I get up early in the morning. So this is the ideal length. Now the examiner is satisfied because I have given him enough reason why I get up early in the morning, rather than only saying yes or no, which is wrong. So try to add some detail or reason or kind of example. If you don't have any reason, you can add an example. Do you get up early in the morning? Of course I get up early in the morning, and I remember that almost every day I get up early in the morning because I have to go for a morning walk, because I think that by waking up early I have enough time to go for a morning run and I can keep myself healthy. So yes, I wake up early in the morning. So this is adding some detail, adding some reason. But there is no ideal length, like I have to speak 3 sentences or 4 sentences. It is only satisfying the examiner with some reasons and with some detail. We don't have to explain too much, okay? We only have to add some detail and giving some reasons, and it can be done if we keep in our mind the why. Every question has a why. Where you go for a morning walk? We can tell the name of the place, but why that place? Or add some detail, with whom we go to that place. So that's all I want to tell you about part 1. I hope this video is useful for you. Thank you very much for watching this video.